MSG. What is it? What is it used for? Is it dangerous? And what does it have to do with racism? Let's find out! Yeah! Hello, my name is Art. I like to eat things. Another thing that I like to do is think about the things that I am putting in my body. There's a lot of information and sometimes misinformation about the foods that we eat. Today, I'll be covering one oft-maligned food that's present in a surprisingly large amount of food that we eat, and that is MSG. Before we begin, a few disclaimers. I am by no means a scientific expert. I'm just a dude who thought science was pretty neat, and I went to college to study it. With that said, I believe that not being an expert shouldn't stop you from learning about, being interested in, and even doing science. There's a little bit of science in everyone. With that, let's begin. MSG stands for monosodium glutamate. This is what it looks like. Sodium is the chemical ion that's responsible for the taste of salt. Table salt itself could even be called monosodium chloride. Glutamate, the other part of MSG, is a naturally occurring amino acid that's responsible for the taste of umami, which is known as the fifth flavor. Umami is a little hard to describe. It's like eating a mushroom without tasting the mushroom flavor, or having a piece of meat without having the meat flavor. It's the taste, or kind of aftertaste, that most people associate with savory foods, and as a result, it has become a very common food additive to improve the flavor of things such as chips, crackers, and soups.
But isn't MSG unsafe to eat?
There has been much debate around the substance, prompted by claims in the late 60s and early 70s that the MSG found in food in Chinese restaurants could cause numbness, heart palpitations, and other health concerns. Further research found that highly concentrated injections of MSG could cause brain cell lesions in the brains of developing mice and rats. As a result of the association between MSG and Chinese food, the term Chinese restaurant syndrome came into use as a derogatory name for MSG sensitivity. However, once the scientific community started to focus on human studies to address the possible dangers of MSG, the results started to become far less clear. Studies done by the United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization, the World Health Organization, the Scientific Committee for Food of the European Commission, and the Food and Drug Administration of the United States all found that MSG was safe for adult human consumption. Some of the studies were even unable to reproduce the brain damage found earlier in mice when giving mice high volumes of orally ingested MSG. Why then is there still so much concern surrounding MSG? I believe that it has something to do with the way that we perceive it as a food, specifically how we perceive it as a racialized food. When I say racialized, I'm referring to how MSG is very, very heavily associated with cheap Asian or Chinese food. The concept of Chinese restaurant syndrome is a pretty clear indicator of how the food has been associated with racial stereotypes from its very introduction. The New York City Health Department went as far as to target Chinese restaurants with warnings against excessive use of MSG, even though MSG is found in tons of food that we would not immediately associate with being Chinese or Asian. These foods include Parmesan cheese, mushrooms, and tomatoes, all of which can include comparable, if not greater, amounts of MSG to that which we would normally expect to find in Asian food. MSG's flavor-enhancing properties have also been capitalized upon by the processed food industry to improve the flavor of a lot of very common snack foods. The flavor generated by MSG, umami, has also recently become a bit of a food trend, with many high-end restaurants injecting their food with high amounts of glutamates to improve the flavor without acknowledging the contentious and racial history behind its use.
I understand what you're saying, but how can you explain the headaches that I get after eating MSG?
One possible consideration is the similarity between the supposed symptoms of MSG poisoning and that of just plain dehydration. Because the taste of umami works to help mask the flavor of salt, foods containing MSG could potentially have higher than normal levels of salt added to further improve their flavor. This could cause the feelings of headache, bloatedness, dizziness, and other symptoms that are often associated with eating MSG. Even beyond that, there is still fair reason to avoid eating MSG. None of the studies that I cited earlier were able to definitively rule out the possibility of MSG sensitivity. As a result, if you suspect that you are sensitive to MSG, you should just avoid eating it, as it's not an essential part of our diets. However, it is very important to base your reasons for avoiding MSG in non-racist ways. Rather than merely avoiding what is considered cheap or low-quality Asian food, people who believe they are MSG sensitive should take care to avoid most processed foods, Parmesan, tomatoes, and mushrooms, in addition to other traditionally Asian foods like soy sauce. Ultimately, it is important to understand the scientific context behind the foods that we eat, in addition to the social and political contexts that influence how we perceive them. As the case of MSG shows, we can inadvertently demonize foods by leaving the issue of race unaddressed, even if the science shows otherwise. So the next time you decide to avoid foods, take the time to think critically about the reasons that you're avoiding them, and try not to avoid food just for racist reasons.